السلام عليكم ورحمة الله بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم Dear learners, I am MD Waliullah, Assistant Teacher of English, Police Line High School, Gumilla. How are you? I hope you are well by the grace of Allah. I am also fine. Dear learners, welcome to the English class. Class 9 and 10. Subject English 2. It is known to us that at the previous class we were starting to discuss the topic right form of verbs. It is known to us and known to you. Right form of verb. We analyzed these topics at the previous class. And we also discussed, we also told before learning right form of verb, we shall have to learn the main three topics: tense, number, person, and formation of verbs. Such kind of things we shall have to learn before learning this topic well, analytically and elaborately. Dear learners, today we shall start from the main point, tense, which is related to the right form of verb accurately. So, I have decided to start to discuss the right form of verb from tense. It is known to us that tense is an elaborate subject, elaborate topics for filling in the gaps or right form of verbs or filling in the gaps. Tense is very important topic. So, we should start from the topic tense. According to tense, from the beginning, we shall discuss right form of verb. Look at this. Now here, if the sentence becomes present indefinite. This is the starting point. If the sentence becomes present indefinite. Present indefinite and the person becomes third person singular. It's an easy matter that main verb we shall have to add s/es with the main verb. Okay, if the sentence becomes present indefinite tense. S or ES, but in respect of auxiliary verb, not S or ES, then we shall have to use is, only is. Okay, in this persons, in this sphere, we shall have to use after the person is, but in respect of main verb. Main verb এর ক্ষেত্রে আমরা s or es যোগ করব কিন্তু auxiliary verb এর ক্ষেত্রে s or es নয় only is. This is the main rule of first rule of present indefinite tense. Okay, actually there are many structures and many rules of present indefinite tense. Another rules are: if the sentence becomes universal truth, scientific truth, habitual fact, natural fact. That means if we get any kind of such kind of sentence in a passage or in a sentence, then we shall have to use the verb in the present indefinite. Okay? Main verb will be used in the present indefinite. That means the verb will be free from ed, en, ing. Okay? The verb will be free ed, en, ing. That means main verb. Only main verb. This will be free from ed, en, ing. If we get this in a sentence. Okay? And in respect of auxiliary verb, only is. in respect of auxiliary verb, only is. Main verb, আমরা এই টপিকগুলো পেলে সবসময় মেইন ভার্বটা ব্যবহার করবো, ইডি ইএন আইএনজি ফ্রি, এগুলো মুক্ত থাকে। আর অক্সিলারি ভার্বের ক্ষেত্রে তো আর ইডি ইএন আইএনজি এগুলো যোগ হবে না, সেখানে কি হবে অনলি ইজ। ওকে, দিস ইজ দ্য রুলস অফ প্রেজেন্ট ইনডেফিনিট টেন্স। দেয়ার আর অলসো অ্যানাদার রুলস অফ প্রেজেন্ট ইনডেফিনিট টেন্স, সো ইউ শুড ক্লিং টু me up to the last. If we get in the sentence, we get in the sentence the below words. Below words, the verb will be used in the present indefinite tense. Present indefinite present. The verb will be used in the present indefinite. The words are always. Often. Generally. Generally, normally, it is. Okay, this is also related to present indefinite tense. If we get in the sentence, says the below words, the verb will be used in the present indefinite tense. Okay, the words are always. Often, generally, normally, it is. That means if we get before the gap, these words, then we shall use the verb in present indefinite tense, not ed. That is also, will be free from ed, en, or ing. Okay? That means in the present indefinite tense. So, dear learners, there are also another structures or rules present in indefinite tense, and no more today. Next class we shall try heart and soul to discuss these topics serially, step or step by step, by the grace of Allah. Thank all of you. May Allah put peace upon you.